Okay, so the emphasis is focusing like a laser beam. So we've talked about this before, and we'll address it again, that when you play in a game of football, it's focusing, putting your attention like a laser beam. But equally, when you're practicing a skill, when you're practicing a skill or a skill, or functional activity, you've really got to focus like a laser beam and maintain a state of relaxation, guys. So we've addressed this before, I talked about this before. Okay, I want to learn something new. I want to learn to kick my left foot. I want to learn how to practice my penalties, my free kicks. You've got to really focus like a laser beam and block everything else outside when you're doing that. Whilst you're doing that, you're sort of going to a state of relaxation. What happens is the brain, the research suggests the rewiring of the brain requires deep, intense focus, but then deep rest, which is why I've talked about hypnosis on this program before. So research suggests that intense focus and rest, the circuits reshape themselves. So the good thing for you guys is the younger you are, the more malleable your brain is, the more you take things on board. The older you get, we know now what we call neuroplasticity, that the brain can rewire itself. But it is obviously harder because, to use an analogy, it's like an algorithm. As we get older, we run these algorithms that we learn as young people. And the reason why is because the brain likes to work on autopilot. Brain requires a lot of energy. So there are times when you're learning a new skill or technique or phase, but you're going to feel tired. Okay. And that's why it's really important that when you visualize or rehearse, you get rest, you give yourself recovery time, not just physically, but mentally too. It's really important that you do that, that you sort of you manage that as well. From the game point of view, one thing that's really important is to, we've talked about this before, is, and sort of Tony, picked up on this a few weeks ago, which is sort of credit to him, who brought this up as well, about me mentioning in the past, focusing on many permutations. So what we mean by permutations is, to use an analogy, it's a bit like, for example, a taxi driver back in the day without the sat nav. You get in a taxi and you say, "Well, take me here," and he or she almost knows automatically because they've been to many of the destinations that you ask them to take you. So, to use a football analogy, you can't, through just experience alone, cover every permutation. You can't even visualize. But the more you do, the more the brain has access to that memory, and the easier it is, because we know the brain likes to work on autopilot, okay, at an unconscious level. So the idea behind the permutations and thinking, okay, I'll write down 50 situations, or maybe five or three, whatever. You can start with one. And what will I do in that situation? It's probably advisable to start with one or two situations and build on that and think, okay, if we go up 1-0, if we go 1-0 down, I'm playing against someone who's quick, or the saying, the first yard is in the head, in the mind. But equally, you're thinking like a snooker player, 20, 30 shots in advance. And you might think, "Oh, no, that requires a lot of energy to get out there and play." I know players, you might think at the highest level, just go out there and play. Well, whether they're doing this consciously, they're doing it because they've sort of stumbled across this. They are doing it because they wouldn't know what to do if otherwise. So you can practice so much physically, but then you've got the issue of overtraining too. So there comes a point where you've got to think, okay, mentally. So I want you to think now for a moment of sort of various permutation. One permutation could be, if you haven't played, obviously, you know, the situation you're in at the moment, you're not playing because the rules and regs, the lockdown rules and regs. Now, when you do play, eventually you're going to play. You know, it goes without saying, obviously, at some point you will play. The idea is, to be on it, not just physically, because you do what you can physically, but also mentally. You're on the front foot straight away. And the way you can do that is rehearse what we've done in previous week mentally, rehearse it mentally, what you're going to do, recap that maybe 5-10 minutes a day if you can, and also think of, okay, well, how will I play? Now, what I've done in the past with my stable of players is get them to look at the fixture list, for example, and think, who are they playing? Okay, this is what I've done and do. You get the fixture list and you look at the fixture list and okay, what grounds will I be playing at? Because the brain likes familiarity. So if we can get to the ground, even to have a look and get a feel for it, it's an advantage. If obviously the person can't get there because it's too far away or somewhere else, maybe look it up on the internet, have a look at it, get a feel of where they're playing. And think about on the fixture list who you're playing against, what style of football they play, and what opposition you'll be playing against. Are they quick? Are they physical? Do they press? And the more you do that, you think, okay, this is exhausting, Jim. Do I have to really do this to play? Well, it's about setting some time aside to do that. It's not spending every hour, every day, every minute, every day doing it. It's spending, say, 5, 10, 15 minutes a day like you would do in the gym. Obviously, when you go to the gym, the rule, whatever, I don't know what the rule in terms of the rules are, or the physical side when you're doing that sort of stuff, you know, like you would do the physical training anyway. You get what I mean? You're taking time every day to do mental training. Because the more mental training you do, the more hardwired you become to do that. So one thing I want you to think about before we sort of move on to the next phase is what are some of the challenges that are going to present themselves to you when you play and be opposition, maybe playing an opposition that press, maybe opposition that got speed, physically strong, certain grounds you may have been in the past and things haven't gone well. Now, this is my opinion, and I'm sure people are going to beg to differ. I've even heard people say that the team who takes the penalty first is an advantage. Well, okay, it's only an advantage if you let it be an advantage, because the fact of the matter is the distance between the penalty and the distance between no problem, George, we'll sort of keep you updated. So the difference between the penalty guys and the goal line is the same. It doesn't change, okay? It's the same distance. So, yeah, psychologically, I'm not naive to think that you might not have an advantage, Yeah, you will do, but that's where psychological training comes in to minimize that and think, well, irrespective of whether I'm taking this penalty now or next, it's still the same distance. I've got the technique. It's the same keeper. I'm going to focus on the process. And there are people saying, well, okay, it's easy for you to say, you're not sort of stepping up. And absolutely, I can entirely agree with all that. And that's why we do the best we can, to replicate a situation. But what it always comes back down to, irrespective of what the situation of the game, is your focus. Where your mind is going. If your focus goes on the outcome, then you forget the process and you go to type and you freeze up. Now, obviously, when it comes to, you know, stepping up, and I have a huge admiration for players who step up and at their very highest level and so on and so forth, but I'm giving my input from a psychological point of view. It's sort of getting to think, okay, it's okay to be afraid. We're all afraid at certain times. But what's really important is that we manage it. We don't let that manage us. we manage the, you know, there's nothing bravado. Well, I'm not afraid. It's fine. Having some fear is okay because it means you care, but channeling that in the right way and doing some of the things we're going to sort of cover, short, like breathing techniques, cue, focus, refocus, which is key, to give yourself the best possible chance to succeed. That's all we can do and ask for. So we're going to sort of look at that now shortly, guys. So I was gonna-